Dear students, good morning to all. Today we can continue with the lesson 3 polynomials exercise 3.1. Okay, the last day we are completed question number 1 and question number 2. Then question number 2, some questions are homework questions. We can check the answers. Okay. So here we can find a quadratic polynomials. Some more zeros are given. The first question, homework question is -1/4, 1/4, zeros is -1/4 and 1/4. Here answer we get k/4 × 4² + x + 1. That is our quadratic polynomial. Here k/4 is constant. Okay. Then next question, 0√5. Here we get polynomial is k × s² + √5. K is constant. Okay. Then next one, 1 and 1 are the zeros. 1 and 1 are zeros. So we can find the quadratic polynomial is, we get k × x² − x + 1, where k is constant. Then last one, 4 and 1. So f(x) = k × x² − 4x + 1, where k is constant. Okay. Are you understand question number 1 and question number 2? Then next question is question number 3. So here question number 3 is, if sum of squares of zeros of a quadratic polynomial f(x) = x² − 8x + k is 40, then find the value of k. Okay, here if sum of squares of quadratic polynomial f(x) = x² − 8x + k, in this question we can find a value of k. Okay, here sum of squares of zeros is given is 40 and polynomial also given. We know that in a quadratic polynomial alpha and beta are the zeros. Okay, alpha and beta are the zeros of a quadratic polynomial. So we can find a value of k. So given polynomial is f(x) = x² − 8x + k. Given polynomial f(x) = x² − 8x + k. We know that alpha and beta are the zeros of quadratic polynomial f(x). Therefore, sum of zeros is alpha plus beta. We know that alpha plus beta equal to -b/a. Here a equal to, check the polynomial x² − 8x + k. Okay, here value of a, that means coefficient of x² is 1. Then value of b, coefficient of x is -8. Then value of c equal to k. Okay, so we get alpha plus beta equal to -b/a. Here -b is -8. So -8 of minus is 8 divided by 1, that is equal to 8. So we get equation number 1 minus, that means alpha plus beta equal to, alpha plus beta equal to 8. That is our equation number 1. Okay. Then product of zeros. We know that product of zeros is alpha beta. Product of zeros is alpha beta. Here alpha beta equal to c/a. We know that c is k, therefore k/1 we get k. So here also we get alpha beta equal to k. That is our equation number 2. Okay, so equation number 1 is alpha plus beta equal to 8 and equation number 2 is alpha beta equal to k. Okay, then now from equation number 1, here equation number 1 is alpha plus beta equal to 8. Take alpha plus beta equal to 8 and squaring both sides. So here squaring both sides means alpha plus beta the whole square equal to 8². So we know that alpha plus beta the whole square is the form of a plus b the whole square. A plus b the whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Therefore, alpha plus beta the whole square is equal to alpha square plus beta square plus 2 alpha beta. That is equal to 64. So, we get alpha square plus beta square plus 2 alpha beta. That is equal to 64. We get equation number 3. So, here equation number 1 is alpha plus beta equal to 8. Then equation number 2 is alpha beta equal to k. And equation number 3 we get alpha plus beta square plus 2 alpha beta equal to 64. Okay, then we know that sum of zeros according to the question, we get sum of squares of zeros is 40. Okay, sum of squares of zeros is 40. We know that sum of squares means alpha plus beta. That means alpha square plus beta square is equal to 40. Okay, alpha square plus beta square is equal to 40. That is our equation number 4. Then putting the values from 2 and 4 in 3. Okay, values from 2. 2 is alpha beta equal to k. And 4 is alpha square plus beta square is equal to 40. Our equation number 3 is alpha square plus beta square equal plus 2 alpha beta equal to 64. Okay. Here alpha square plus beta square is equal to 40. Putting the value alpha square plus beta square is 40. Plus 2 into alpha beta. We know that alpha beta equal to k. That is 2k equal to 64. Okay. So here we can find the value of k. Our question is we can find the value of k. So 2k equal to 64 minus 40. Okay. So 64 minus 40. Therefore k equal to, that means 2k equal to 24. 64 minus 40 is 24. Therefore, k equal to, which implies k equal to 24 divided by 2. That is 12. We get k equal to 12. Thus, the value of k is 12. Are you understand this question? So, here we can find the value of k in our quadratic polynomial. The given question, sum of squares is 40. So we know that the relation of alpha plus beta and alpha beta. So we get value of k. K equal to 12. So similarly, question, if sum of zeros of a quadratic equation kx square plus 5x plus 3k is equal to their product. So we can find the value of k. This question is Homer question. Okay, thank you.